Time to press ahead. Wish I had a bag of holding. What's inside? No way to ignite these. Strange. No way to ignite these. Strange. Better not be cursed.
I applaud your taste.
All's well that ends.
None of that.
Moving ahead.
I feel the collar stirring in my pack. Something must be triggering the rune's magic.
Yes?
We're a long way from Waterdeep.
Clever.
Give a dog a magical food dispensing collar and I'm sure it will eat. It seems to have run out of food disappointingly quickly.
disc is formed from slate and engraved with Githyanki writing. You examine them closely, but can't make much sense of them. Without a cipher or primer to aid you, the disc's message could be near impossible to discern. In your mind's eye, the symbols trade places with each other until a clear pattern forms. And from that pattern, a story emerges. The Prince of the Comet, Part 1. So it was that we were free from Gaik shackles and turned our blades on each other. The heavens were shattered, and one great empire was divided in two. Gith traveled to the Hells to broker help for her people. Her cause. Flaketh would have you believe Mother Gith proclaimed her our queen. Lies. Gith made no such proclamation. Flaketh seized the empire against the mother's wishes, but Gith had nurtured a son, Orpheus, Prince of the Comet, the true heir. He knew Flaketh's treachery. Orpheus rallied Gith's honor guard and declared the throne for himself. The War of the Comet had begun. It's an intriguing tale, and a forbidden one, given how expertly it was encoded. Laezel will surely want to know of this.
Strange disc. Are these Githyanki markings? Have a look.
She is cataloging Coatoan fertility rituals.
Welcome back. Have you made any new discoveries? I do enjoy a good bargain, if anything in my private collection is to your liking. Very well.
The disc appears in your mind's eye. Lazel sees it too, and considers the vision.
Tissue markings. Ancient. I recognize them, but I can't make sense. No. Wait. The texts are enciphered, but I've solved the pattern. It's a story. About Orpheus.
Your head buzzes in concert with Lazel's, but it hardly matters. Even without the connection, you'd recognize her discomfort.
Githyanki writing. Every word a wheel. Every letter a spoke. The most powerful texts are engraved in slate. Some so ancient, only the most erudite Gish can read them. Drivel, all of it. Gith declared Vlakith queen of the Empire, and her own son defied her. Orpheus would have ceded control to the Geich. She did nothing of the sort. Thank your good fortunes, I'm a tolerant woman, or I'd have sliced off a few toes for suggesting it. Mark my words, this power would be no blessing, but a curse. You might as well ask me to gouge out my eyes for the promise of sight, or slice off my tongue for the promise of taste. Consume all the Geith tadpoles you wish. I'm not so craven. Perhaps you... No, that's absurd. When the tadpole has stretched to every pore and slithered through every vein, what am I to do then? It won't hear my screams. It won't care if I beg. I will be remade in its image. My faith in Vlakith will guide me, and my own might will sustain me. I have no need of this depraved power. You're wasting your time and mine. The answer is...
shall find me. No rest for the wicked, I see.
What to do?
Personal research progressing.
Our work is bigger than any one of us, even Walden.
Bibberbet. Of course.
We'll be clearing. You come across a noble stock mushroom about, you give it here. Gods know I've earned it. That old idiot.
I'll have to be more watchful next time.
Can't give up now.
Welcome back. I do enjoy a good bargain, if anything in my private collection is to your liking. Very well.
I'll give it a shot.
How is your more...
Trader has no problem with you inspecting these goods, so long as you're willing to pay for them. Trader appears encouraged by your interest in this item, though of course you'll need to pay for it.
Is it the foam? That foul, contemptuous heel. An unbeknownst command by fools that would intrude. Now steel shall ring. False tongue will speak no more.
Shall be done.
Chair leg might be good for smacking monsters around.
Thank you.
Time for some bloody work.
It's good to be alive.
Quite ready for you. These things have stayed interesting.
New sounds to dampen like a pressure break. Is it the foe? That foul, contemptuous heel. Come out of love for me. Not love for blood and steel. Command as you feel, my lord. My liege.
Don't get me wrong. I love poetry as much as the next wizard, but using it to command an automaton seems a bit self-indulgent to me.
A minute's wake, it tramples everything. We'll kill the rest, so that the one can thrive.
Favors the fearless. Dollar. I don't fancy their chances.
Ha! Waste a step.
Don't mind if I do.
Something's on my mind.
Fate, dost thou require a new ally? Or mayhaps a resurrection instead? Then thou must return with the proper payment. This is the price of balance. Well counted. By doom and dusk, I strike thy name from the archives. Rise. Ah.
Well met. Tell me, what can I do for you?
Oh, hi.
The cub pecks at a crimson splash on his leg. Looks at you with glistening eyes. With a sad hoot, he holds out his paw, revealing a wound. The wound closes. The cub begins testing his weight on the leg.
I love him so much!
Hmm.
defender of the people.
Shouldn't have wished to live in more interesting times. With haste.
Very well.
The dog is unable to speak through the small bag he holds in his mouth.
I don't know. Maybe you can tell me. All I know is I thought of you when I saw it.
May the darkness protect you.
Well, hello. What can I do for you?
Hello. You are not food. You are friend. Nice here. The caves smell like rotting meat. Goblin cat smells like goblins. Ooh, more.
Hope you're keeping well, friend.
Sir Melium is right. I should get a mask. Welcome back. Have you made any new discoveries? Let me see if it will answer my summons a second time.
Ah, Blurg. Are you in need?
Welcome back. I do enjoy a good bargain. If anything in my private collection is to your liking. Very well.
Have you? I greet you, Sun Child. May your travels be safe. Difficult to emulate.
Let's see what this does.